स्टार्ट।
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, टुडे वी डिस्कस ऑन लॉस ऑफ हेड थ्रू पाइप्स। सो लॉस ऑफ हेड थ्रू पाइप्स, हाउ इट विल कम, हाउ लॉस विल जनरेट एंड हाउ लॉस विल कम, मींस व्हेन द फ्लो इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू ए पाइप, दिस इज ड्यू टू प्रेशर, दिस इज ड्यू टू प्रेशर। सो व्हेन प्रेशर इज देयर इन अ फ्लूइड फ्लो, व्हेन इट इज कमिंग through a pipe, then there is some pressure. Due to that pressure, some loss will be generated, and that loss is accumulated in calculate when we are calculating any formulation or any discharge or any power transmitted in the pipe. So this loss of head through pipe is very important chapter, one of the very important chapter in flow through pipes. So today we will discuss on loss of head through pipe, Darcy Weisbach equation and minor losses. And major loss is Darcy Weisbach equation, which due to the friction, that is the Darcy Weisbach equation. And other losses, there are 7-8 losses are there, that is minor losses. So first coming, what are the loss of head, in pipes? Those are listed here. When the water flow in a pipe, it experiences some resistance to its motion, means there is some friction, the pipe flow is occurring due to the pressure, and there is some resistance in the boundary, and that is called loss due to motion, and which creates some resistance to the flow, due to which the velocity and ultimate head of water available is reduced. Due to that friction, ultimate head of the water as well as the velocity is going to reduce. So this loss of energy or head loss is classified as below, that is divided into two sub criteria, that is major loss and another is minor loss. So in major loss, this is basically due to loss head due to friction, and the second one is minor losses. There are 7 losses are there, so we will discuss one by one. The first one is major loss, that is due to the friction, and the minor energy losses are due to, first one is loss of head due to sudden enlargement, then due to sudden contraction, loss of head due to an obstruction in the pipe, and fourth one is due to the entrance of the pipe, means when the pipe is coming from an entrance, there is some loss, and that is due to the entrance of the pipe. Loss of head at exit of the pipe, the loss of head due to bend of the pipe. Okay, you can see in practical field also there are some bend, all the pipes are not straight, there are some bend, because due to the site selection also we need to bend that pipe, or the pipe bends are available, we can use that one. Due to that also some losses are there. Loss of head in various pipe fittings. Okay, so first we will discuss on major energy losses, that is called Darcy Weisbach equation. Okay, so coming to the Darcy Weisbach equation, the loss of head due to the friction in the pipe flow, and in case of turbulent flow, in here we are considering only turbulent flow, not pipe flow, because the turbulent flow in real field, the turbulent flow is available than the laminar flow. So the turbulent flow through a pipe, it has been observed through experiment that this viscous friction effect associated with the fluid are proportional to, that is the length of pipe, that is denoted as capital L, then weighted perimeter, that is capital P, and V to the power N. V to the power N means the V is the average velocity and N is the exponent, that is an index which varies from 1.5 to 2. Sometimes it is varies from 1.75 to 2. So this figure you can see here, this figure shows the forces uncontrolled volume of a pipe flow. The pipe flow is a very long, what we are considering here is small element of a pipe flow. And in that we are dividing it, or we are considering two different sections. One is section 1-1, which is near to the inlet of the pipe, and section 2-2, which is at the outlet of the pipe. So here we can see the P1, small P1 means the intensity of pressure at section 1-1, and P2 is the pressure at section 2-2. Okay, and this is totally pipe. You can see it is a pipe, and this is the plan view. So it is a rectangular one. But where generally it is a circular pipe. But circular pipe, when you see in the top, na, that is the plan. So that plan view is here, it is shown. So the plan view is the rectangular. Okay, so you can see this is the top mark. You can see here that is the cross section. Okay, so then P1 is intensity of pressure at section 1-1, already I described this one, and length of the pipe is capital L. Capital L means the length in between section 1 to section 2, okay, not the total length, because we are considering a specific control volume, means control section. So the length of the pipe is capital L, means not section 1 to section 2. And HF, the head loss due to friction, okay, which we need to find out. And F dash, that is the non-dimensional factor whose value depends upon the material and nature of the pipe. Okay, it depends upon the nature of the pipe as well as material, which material you are going to use. Suppose mild steel or plastic or PVC, any pipe material is there. So as for that material, the value will be different. Then propelling force on the flowing fluid between the two sections. Here is the two sections, section 1, section 2. The propelling force means the difference between the force. Okay, so P1 and P2 into cross-sectional area. The force means how we will find the force, pressure into cross-sectional area. So we will get the force. So here the pressure is P1 minus P2. That is the pressure difference into cross-sectional area, so that we can get the force. And that force is known as propelling force. That force is known as propelling force. Then frictional resistance force. Frictional resistance force. This is the propelling force, means due to the water, it is under pressure, and that is the propelling force. But there is some friction, as I told before in some slides, that there is some friction resistance, and due to that, some resistance force is induced. And that force is defined as, or called as, F prime P, capital P, and capital L, B square. Okay, and P here is weighted perimeter, here P is weighted perimeter, and B is the average flow velocity. Okay, so under equilibrium condition, what is the equilibrium condition? So whatever propelling force is there, that should be equal to the frictional resistance force. Okay, that is the equilibrium condition. Means as you can say, the inlet force, okay, means the induced force should be the exit force. Okay, in Raman's equation and in continuity equation, you can say the inlet flow should be equal to the outlet flow. Okay, that is the equilibrium condition. And here it is the equilibrium condition, is propelling force should be equal to frictional resistance force. Okay, and here propelling force is already we have defined, P1 minus P2 into cross sectional area. And frictional force is F dash E L B square. Okay. So dividing both sides by weight density, that is small w. Then we have, when we are dividing the small w, weight density, then we will get P minus P2, P1 minus P2 by W into A is equal to F dash by W P L B square. Okay. So when we are simplifying this, we can get HF is equal to, HF is the frictional head, as discussed in the previous slide. That is HF is equal to F dash by W the P by A into A B square. Okay. But then what is the HF? HF means P by P minus P2, P1 minus P2 by W. That is the HF. And A is coming here, then it is divided into the right side. Okay. And HF is equal to QGF dash by W. The P by A LB square by 2G, means we are dividing both sides by 2G. So we will get finally 2gf dash w into l by m. M means that is the ratio between p by a and b square by 2g. Okay. Then ratio a by p is called hydraulic mean depth or hydraulic radius, that is denoted by m. Already I discussed this. Also, in some books it is written as capital R. Capital R means that is known as hydraulic radius. Okay, hydraulic radius, which I have adopted from, that is the denotion denoted by m, but you can denote as R also. Okay, so the term L by m into b square by 2g has a dimension of hf, and thus the term 2gf by w is a non-dimensional quantity. So in this situation, you can see L by m b square by 2g, it is a dimension. There is some dimension, but 2gf by w, there is dimensionless quantity. So in one equation, dimensionless quantity and dimensional quantity, both we can keep. So we have to generalize this equation. We have to generalize this equation. Where will we generalize? To replace the another constant f. To replace another constant f, so that it will be generalized. So hf is equal to, we can write this equation, hf is equal to in terms of 2gf dash by w, we have to replace that small f, and the ln, the l by m into b square by 2g, keep it as f. Okay. Now in case of circular pipe, we can see the m, that hydraulic radius is a by p, and this is the formula for a, and this is the formula for p, and d by 4. Substituting this value in equation here, the equation here, then you can get hf is equal to f into l by d by 4 into b square by 2g. Then finally, we will get 4fl b square by 2gd. And this is the most important formula which we are going to use, that is Darcy Weisbach equation or Darcy coefficient of friction, that is 4fl b square by 2gd, and this is the head loss due to friction. The above equation is known as Darcy Weisbach equation, as we have discussed, and this is the figure which we have adopted here. Okay, so next one is the force due to the shear force. Means this is also we can write in terms of shear stress. So we have to replace the p minus p2 d by 4 into tau naught. Tau naught means that is the shear stress. Shear stress at the pipe wall. So we have to replace, and we can get in terms of shear stress, the value will be, finally we will get f is equal to 2 tau naught by rho v square. Okay. Coming to the Bernoulli's equation, so how the loss of head is coming? Due to the Bernoulli's equation, you can see here, there is no head loss. There is no head loss, and there is different head, that is pressure head, kinematic head, and this is datum head. So within this, all the head, this is called section 1 and section 2, the Bernoulli's equation will come. And the Bernoulli's equation says, all the summation of head equal to at one section should be equal to the section 2. And in the real fluid, and this is for ideal fluid because there is no head loss. But in real fluid, we can tell that there should be some head loss. There should be some head loss, and that is only in real fluid, not in ideal fluid. And that is the head loss, and head loss due to friction. So you can see with the example I can tell also in here, to suppose at section 1 the energy is 100 kN per meter, and in section 2 that is 95 kN per meter, and head loss is how much? That is HF is equal to 5 kN per meter. So this is all about the head loss due to friction, and this is the final equation from the Bernoulli's equation, that in the second, at the outlet of the equation, we can add from head loss due to friction. Okay. And this is the head loss due to friction. The summarized, I have summarized all these things, and all the nomenclatures are here. And F is equal to 0.0791 by Reynolds number to the power 1 by 4. This is due to varying from 4000 to 10 to the power 6. This is due to the Reynolds, depends upon the Reynolds number, and this purely turbulent fluid. Okay, this is on turbulent fluid. And the length of the pipe is L, and B is the mean velocity and diameter of the pipe. Okay. So this is the boundary equation and this is the hair loss due to friction. Okay. So now today we will finish this class. See you in next class. Thanks for attending the class.